Hey everyone, this is Gary with Honeybees Unlimited. It's winter time, so we're out here moving our bees, trying to get them back to our main yard so we can get them ready to ship off to California in about a month, or I guess about five, six weeks before we gotta get them all merged and up the strength to go to California. So as that weeks come, we'll be showing you some of that preparation, but I thought tonight I might wanna tag along while we load up some bees. All right, stop number two. Thank you.
Was that open the whole time?
Stop number three. This is our third to last stop. I think I misspoke earlier when I said, we were moving 16 hives. Actually, we're moving 10 pallets tonight, which is 40 hives. One more stop to go. Hopefully we don't get stuck in this field. Been a while since it rained, but you never know. Some of these old fields I used to grow crops on, they're pretty loose. Hopefully Clay will get this gate open here soon. We can pull through. Those of you that are hobbyists, you're on the right side. Yeah, those are usually our hobbyists that are looking to be a sideliner or sideliners looking to go commercial. One thing I would recommend is getting mechanized as soon as you can. You need to, if you can get your bees onto four-way pallets and migratory tops, it's just gonna save you a lot in the long run. You won't be buying all those single bottom boards and putting them. Just get on pallets as soon as you can. It really helps once everything's mechanized, and you can be moving things around. We like to move bees at night. Moving bees in the winter is always nice because you get to start late or start early. Start at 5. There he goes. Yeah, moving bees in the summertime, that's a whole different game because you got to move it. Start at 9. Hopefully tonight, that's when we finish. You gonna get in the truck? You can leave it open. They're just right up here. You can walk. This is one of our honeybee sanctuaries in Cook County. Last two were in Denton County. Next to her singles, we're gonna have to add an empty box to the top of each one of them so we can strap them down and the load will ride properly. Put them on top of the lids. Leave the lids on. It's cold. You're gonna have to fix that front one. Hang on, I got it. Be able to get the board on there and strap it down. Apparently they take their Christmas lights really serious out here in the country. On our way to our last yard. This is just too much. our last stop of the night. This one's a little tight, so we'll have to load up from the road. Bit of a hole here. These are some heavy hives. I don't want to drop them. Sure is nice moving on cold nights. Those bees like to stay inside. Bees do come out on these cold nights, but they don't fly. They just crawl around. Hey, Clay. Is that pin pulled? Is the pin next stop, headquarters. Meanwhile, back at HQ. We'll come in here, we'll drop the trailer and unload these bees. Thank you.
right, we use our little survey flags to mark our hives. Trust me, these are green. They don't look like it under light. But today, green means new to the yard. They need to be inspected.
Time to unload.
These are heavy. Don't wait on me.
Start filling holes?
Yep.
Right. Right behind you. Keep right here. All right. Keep, just walk backwards.
Yeah, we're filling these holes because we're running out of space in the yard. We've been making a lot of merges. So we just wanted to come do it this way. If we do it right now at night, these bees don't know this location, so they're not gonna, next time it's nice, they'll orient properly. Looks dead.
Anywhere?
Yeah, just anywhere you find a hole. Right there is a good one. It's good in the front. Mark it with the green flag so we know to come back and inspect it.
thanks for joining us tonight. Yeah, we got 10 pallets moved with about 40 hives. It's kind of a messed up way we had to do it tonight. We're running out of space in our main yard because we've been doing a lot of merges and pulling a lot of dead outs from that were out in the field that we were just finding right now. So that's why we had to take them with the hand truck and move them to different pallets, because we're just running out of space. Normally we just drop the pallets and keep going, but anyways, thanks for joining us tonight. If you like it, please like and subscribe. See you next time.